My name is Jason Brooks. I'm down from Alaska. I work for the BLM, Alaska Fire Service, where I'm the Unit Aviation Manager for the Tanawha Zone. I'm here on the Schneider Springs Fire as a qualified UAS manager working with the Type 1 call when needed UAS. And we got here is the Bridger FV-90 Type 1 drone.
My name is Kelly Lewis. I work for the Alaska Fire Service, BLM. Fire here. I am a UAS manager trainee, so I'm here with the Type 1, which is the only available Type 1 aircraft in the nation right now on this fire. We're designed to stay up over the fire through smoke and through the night operations in order to provide real SA for the folks on the ground. We actually have a Zoom link that all the divisions can just observe the fire all day, all night long, what we're doing. So there's this real-time feed, and it's key at night too for burn operations and picking up spots with reduced folks out there.
So yeah, with the Type 1 drones here, when we come into play, we get ordered up through the IROC system, and we'll get our resource order, working with you know, me as a manager, trainee, and data specialist, as well as the vendor gets a resource order, and make our way to the fire. Typically it takes about 24 to 36 hours before we're set up. We've got some logistics stuff that we have to set up before we can start flying right away. Part of that is making sure that there's a TFR in place. We get a special government interest waiver through some agreements with the FAA that we work through our coordinator down in Boise in order for us to fly beyond visual line of sight within that TFR. On the fire itself, we got to find multiple launch and recovery zones. That allows us to kind of have our own portion of the airspace within the TFR that allows us to basically spool up or come down within that before transitioning over to the fire. This year, we're exclusively doing night operations. In the past, we have done day operations where we're coordinating directly with air attack, Hello Base, and the other aircraft in order to provide safe aerial operations. Working with the ops group in order to provide some real-time data, situational awareness over the fire at night so they can kind of see what's happening with their fire, identify any sort of hot spots or potential hazards outside the line with the fire. As well as just kind of help them monitor their progression of any burns.
We're able to do a lot of the gritting in the green for folks so they don't have to walk through snag patches at night. And we can accomplish and make a better plan for the next day's shift with the intel that we gather all night long. We're treated like any other aircraft. We call out in the airspace. We have our tail number. And then we coordinate with the other UAS that are on the line. We also need a really wide area to take off from because this is a vertical. It goes straight up and then it transitions forward. And then within the TFR, we have a launch and recovery zone, which is just a cone. We stay within this one nautical mile cone. And we climb and climb and climb to about 10,000 feet and then we'll transition out and then up to 13,000. The reason we need to go so high is the controller over there needs to be able to talk to the drone. So the higher up you are, the better line of sight you have with the controller. So if we have hills or mountains in our way, then or trees, we can't have that conductivity. So this is a beautiful spot. And then we do have internet service here, so we're able to do the Zoom. And then when they come to land, very open area, you don't have to worry about much around here.
Hey, Kyle Wright, and I'm here as a UAS data specialist with a Type 1 drone, a contractor-owned drone. And what the data specialist does is we're here to provide data not only to the contractor, but into the folks on the ground to really get that near real-time situational awareness about the fire so they can make better fire decisions. Right now we're mostly flying at night. Most other fire fighting aircraft can only fly in the day. So we provide a great situational awareness for that nighttime fire activity. So flying at night, we really rely on our IR or infrared camera system. So we have both a gimbaled mounted camera that is kind of on a ball that can rotate up and down, and we have a nadir fixed camera that is facing straight down. And we use those two camera systems for different things. That gimbaled based camera is really that, where's the fire? and giving that feedback back to the ground. The downward facing camera is more for potential mapping missions, but really our bread and butter is, where's the fire? Is it going where they want to? Is it not? What actions can the folks on the ground make better decisions based on our intel? So we were able to use some real-time information via online calls for this, so they can see a video of the from the platform where they are, where the fire is, and what actions they can take. Last night, we saw a spot fire, we saw an engine, we told the engine, go to the spot fire. We're that accurate to where we can say, this is a spot over the line, and then act upon those things. It's a super remarkable tool. Our bread and butter is that real-time situational awareness. This is where the fire is, this is where it's going, and then they can act upon that. So then we're giving them different perspective that they might not typically get from the ground. And I think that perspective and that just overwatch from the platform just pays huge dividends in that wildland fire decision making.
Trying to portray to the general public is that, if folks have their private pilot license or their other drones, any intrusion to the TFR, basically shuts down all our operations, whether that's manned or unmanned. We just don't want to ever take the chance of running into somebody or whatnot.
Awesome. Last question for you is, what's your favorite part of the job?
All right. Favorite part of my job here is, it's just providing that real-time situational awareness to the operation folks on the ground. A lot of times, they're burning out. They can't see that they're getting ember wash over the line or how far out. I had occasions where we were able to walk people into hot spots. On this fire, we found a couple hot spots. We were within like 8 feet and a foot, looking at one-by-one spot fires that were in places that the folks on the ground wouldn't be able to find until maybe it got established.
The favorite part of the job is actually feeling that you maybe saved somebody from having to walk down a steep slope into an unsafe situation, or providing intelligence so that the day shift can make a better plan, a more educated plan with what's going on the ground. So limiting firefighter exposure and providing that intel to the folks on the ground. That's really why we're here.
I think the favorite part working with these drones is it's an ever-evolving scenario, and we're ever-evolving in terms of the products we can get out to the ground. So we're really always trying to improve ourselves every night, get a better product, get what they need so they can make better decisions on the ground.